Right, so, okay. So basically, this machine, if you've ever been in tunnels, I'm sure some of you have been to London, okay, you've been down in the tube. So these are the machines that actually build the tunnels, okay? So what is it composed of? We've got the front bit, which is the impressive part of the machine. This is the cutter head, so this turns and eats the soil as we go. There's these holes, gnarly bits, really sharp, and obviously these would be made of some really hard material on the front, probably tungsten. And there's all sorts of bits that do the cutting of the soil. So once that happens, the soil drops down in the wheel. And if you walk around, I'll take you through the rest. Okay, so if you just all walk around nice and gently, mind your cables in mind these. Okay. We'll do a question shortly, okay? Just make sure you've got good space, okay? Okay, shush, okay? So the next part of the machine, the soil basically comes up through the bottom. Some of you might be able to see this corkscrew arrangement, this big item in the middle, so it's a bit difficult to see. And then the soil then comes up at the top, and some of you will be able to see the conveyors, but we'll have a proper look at that in a second. The next part of the machine is, how does it build the tunnel itself? So obviously this big chunk in the front, that just keeps eating the soil. It's like a giant worm, okay? But out the back, it actually builds the tunnel. So this whole element is like a big factory, big manufacturing place. So you can see here, these are the tunnel rings. This is what supports the soil. And this is a mock of one of the tunnel segments that this is made of. There are 35 of those on this model, which in itself means it's about 12,000 pieces. But hold that thought. So basically, these are what come through on the construction railway. So as the machine advances, these come from the surface, from other factories on the construction railway, and they go through up to the front. What happens then is the segment is picked up by the ring builder. Okay, so this machine basically rotates in two ways. It goes around there. You can pick the segments up and twist them in all sorts of ways. I was too lazy to build the bit that did that, but I think you'll give me the benefit of the doubt. So they pick up the segment rings, and then this ring builder actually moves forward and backwards to be able to place this in its respective place. And then what happens is they're bolted together, and the machine, using these big rams, so there's rams all the way around, it pushes its whole cell forward based on those tunnel rings it's just put in. So it keeps moving forward on that basis. So that's basically how they work. The rest of the machine at the back, as you can imagine, is quite heavy. This actually then runs load on the tunnel ring itself by those wheels. So it just continually builds the tunnel. Okay, so that's the theory, but I'd like to see it do something. I'm sure that you would. Okay, cool. So I've got some balls in my pocket. These are the Knex balls. I'm sure some of you have got these at home. These represent the soil. Okay, so if we just get some of this working. So put some electric in. So that's not that spectacular, I'll be honest. It's a bit buried in there, but what you've got is a series of conveyors. It takes the soil through up there and then up to the top. And obviously in real life that would just continue back all the way to the surface, or it would discharge into a muck train so it can be took out. So that's that part. The next bit gets a bit noisy at this point, so this is the big corkscrew I was telling you about earlier. So that goes, you can probably see that moving just in there, that big long piece that goes down to the front. Okay. Okay, and then the next bit, of course, if you go around the front, you'll see the cutter wheel. Hopefully it'll be okay. So
don't give me any idea.
Okay, so basically what happens is these balls or the soil, okay? And the thing pushes forward onto the soil, and the soil falls in these holes and it gets abraded by these cutting teeth. Okay? That goes in here, and then eventually through a series of ramps, the soil then finds its way down into the bottom, or out the front in this case. Okay? So they should basically come into this part just there, and then eventually they come out the back of the machine on the conveyor belt. Okay, so that's basically how it works. Because what used to happen before these machines existed, there used to be people at the front with a big frame, and they'd actually dig with a shovel at the front.
Really?
And have to,
oh my
yeah,
God.
Had to do it all manually. Work. So those tunnels, if you've been in London, if you know where the Victoria Line is, for example, that was built like that. Basically, what was a shield, they go in, shovel it out, and you should look at some pictures. Very, very interesting. So these machines are really quite important.
When did you start building this?
I started building this last March. And wow. I don't know why, but I just decided the cut ahead should be about as tall as I am.
When did you finish it?
That's why it's big. Finished it in about February time. And so it's about nearly a year. It nearly took me a year because I have a job, obviously, so I've got to just fit it in weekends, spare time. But there we go. So yeah, you're back.
Of me. How did you get it here?
How did I get it here? On that. We hired a crane, which has saved a lot of bother. It's very heavy, actually. How heavy do you think it is?
Very.
Very. I'm expecting
700. It's a bit less than that. We reckon it's about a quarter of a ton. It's quite heavy. There's a lot of plastic in it. Obviously, the plywood makes a bit of weight as well, but it's very, very heavy. Yeah, go for that. Yeah, because I'm really short, right? So I mean, you were taller than me. So I had to get a step ladder and just kind of go on the top. So that was, that's how we got onto that one. That's a good point, actually, because I did actually start this in my bedroom. So I started with the front, built the wheel, and then started to think about, okay, I could build the next bits, and I quickly realised it wouldn't fit out the door. So we had to take some parts off and actually get it out of the house. But that was very hard, and then it went to the shed, and then after the shed it went to that trailer and the garage. So we actually had to take the neighbour's fence down to get it out, which was fun, yeah. Okay, that's happy.
What inspired you to make this?
Oh, really great question. Really great question. So I think of all the construction equipment, you make e-diggers or dumpers, forklift trucks, this is one of the most interesting pieces of construction equipment that exists, in my opinion. I think there's a lot to it. It's obviously a bit unique, and that's what inspired me to do it, really. And I've been in a real life one of these as well. I used to work with these machines, and very, very interesting.
Wow. How big are these compared to, like, people?
Well, it's funny you say that, actually, because these come in different sizes, okay? So there are actually real life tunnel boring machines that are this size. So they actually dig sewers and they dig small tunnels. But the bigger ones, they can go all the way up to bigger than your school.
Oh my God.
It reminds me of Thunderbirds. When I used to watch Thunderbirds, and that used to, they've got one of these.
Boxes, as you can see here, I've been collecting these. They're all second hand, so there's nothing been like bought new. It's very, very cheap. So tell your parents if they want to buy you some to get it on eBay, because it's much easier, much cheaper. I've got it's about 75 here, something like that. And I bought two old models from a shop that were in a shop window for years. So I have around about 250,000 pieces in total at home. So I've still got a lot of this stuff. But I did start running out of certain pieces when I got to the end, and that kind of, I had to stop there really and thought, this is getting a bit silly. So that's what it is. But in real life, these machines, I mean, these are the interesting parts, of course. So the rest of this would actually be in real life about three times longer than this for the rest of the factory. But I think these bits are the most interesting. So we stopped there. Yeah.
If you put real sharp things on,
I don't think it could make actual tunnels. It barely got here in one piece, so it's definitely not strong enough to make a real tunnel.